Hi, welcome to an Onshape video tutorial. I want to do that hexagon grill exercise in Onshape. Sadly, Onshape still lacks a lot of necessary commands, but I could do it, and so let's have fun with Onshape. Okay, let's start with a sketch on the front plane. I need a circle. Diameter should be 600. Then I need some lines, some just for construction, some as references for my circular patterns. So let's make first these construction lines here. Let's trim and align those points horizontal, this one and that one, and give it a dimension, and that dimension might be 80 degrees. Then I need a line for, let's go for 200 in length. And another one, maybe like this, again 200 in length. And both of these should be, of course, for construction. Okay, confirm and close that sketch. Let's make a surface revolve. Go for revolve, go for surface, select the sketch. The revolve axis should be this one. Let's go for symmetric. And let's go for 35 degrees. Let's take a look. So go for 70 degrees. Yeah. And confirm. Now I need a plane tangent to that surface. So let's take a look what we have here. So do we have tangent? Not really, so we'll go for one with an offset from this one. Not this one, but no. That's really, really annoying, from the top plane, like this. Okay, confirm. And of course the distance should be not 0 but 300, and that would be a tangent plane to this one. Now let's go for our sketch and hexagon on that plane. Look from the top, go for a polygon. And that polygon should have six sides, yes, and arrange it like that, yeah. Six, yes. No, six. Okay, and give it a dimension, and that dimension should be 10. And confirm and close that sketch. Now I cannot project this one onto that surface, so I will do it in a different way. I will go for splines and maybe hide that surface for the moment. Hide surface one. So I need some lines. In this case I will go for splines because they're easier to draw than a sketch. So the splines should be here. I can go a projected curve, but that's not the projection I need. So go for 3D split spline from that point up to this point. Confirm. go for another one and bring back that sketch. Let's go from this point to that one. Confirm another spline here, here. Confirm. Of course, I could do a circular pattern, but I want to do it in a different way because then it's easier to split that surface. Confirm. So one is missing. There you go. Now let's try to make full surfaces. Yeah. Oh, there's still one missing. So I need one from this to the origin. And now I want to try to make full surfaces. So this one didn't work. That one didn't work. That's hard to see. Okay. Go for point here and of course the point there. That should work. Yes. Now let's go for the full surfaces. They should be somewhere here. Fill. And I want to fill this one with that one and that small one. Confirm. Now I want to add another one, so go for fill, but go for add. So that would be this edge, and this one. Confirm. So this shouldn't be two, yeah, it's two surfaces, that's okay. Let's add another fill. Add, select, 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 confirm. Did this work? No, it didn't. Great. Yeah, I got the wrong one. So I wanted this line and that line. Confirm. Add another one, add this edge, and this one. Confirm. Two more. So select this edge, that edge, and this one. Confirm. And the last one. Fill, edge or spline, doesn't really matter, edge or spline, that's again a wrong one, I need this one, okay, and confirm. So now I got one surface and another surface, so I got two surfaces. And now I should be able to split that surface with this surface. Let's go for a split. Part of surface is yes. I want to split this surface with the second one, this one. I don't want to keep the tools, so confirm. Now I should have two surfaces. Yes, I could hide those splines. Hide all curves. Yeah. Let's show our first sketch. The first one, there's the first one, sorry. Not the second one. And now I want to make a circular pattern. Should I first thicken that and then pattern, or first pattern and then thicken? I go for first pattern then thicken. So let's take a look in which direction we want to go. We want to go in that direction. So go for a circular pattern. And I want to pattern this surface right here. And the axis would be that one. No, that's the wrong one. Yeah, of course it's the wrong one. It should be this one. That's the surface, that's the edge. Yes, and you could go for face pattern or for a part pattern. I go for a part pattern. And I want it to be 3 degrees and 4 instances, not 6 instances. And that's wrong. Y angle 3 degrees, instance 6, yes, but the other way around. Like that, and confirm. Now I want to thicken those with 1 millimeter. So go for, where is it? Thicken should be somewhere over here. Yes, thicken. And faces and surfaces, yes. And let's go for 0.5 and no, 1 millimeter in the one direction and 1 millimeter in the other direction. And let's thicken this one. Could have thickened more, yes. I could go for another thicken, another thicken, another one, another one, and the last one. And confirm. Now I want to move those. And I need another sketch for the axis, so go for a sketch on that plane. Let's draw a line just for construction from this point in that direction. Length doesn't really matter, let's go for 100 and close that sketch. Okay, let's transform those parts. I could hide the surfaces all. Yeah. Now I want to transform these. So go for, where is it? There it is. Transform. I want to transform this one, that one, and this one. Not by a line, but I want to rotate it around this axis. And it should be 1.75 degrees and confirm. Now let's hide the plane for a moment. And I want to pattern those. So go for a circular pattern. I go for centered, I go for 3.5 degrees, and I need 11, so 10 to every side. Entities to pattern, this one, that one, this one, that one, this one, that one, and the axis should be this one. And it's not equal spacing. This looks okay, so confirm. Great. Now I want to mirror those top 4 lines. So go for mirror. Where's the mirror command? There you go. And I want to mirror these. And I don't want to mirror those. So let's try to select them all by one if possible. Let's try it like this. Well, that's a little bit too much, but that doesn't matter. I will deselect the one I don't need. This one should be removed, that's okay. And the mirror plane would be that one. And confirm. Okay, I need a new sketch on my hidden plane. So bring back the plane. And let's go for a sketch on that plane. And that should be a rectangle. I could hide the parts. So let's hide them all, at all parts. And I could hide that sketch too as well. And I go for a rectangle, a center point rectangle. And this could be 340 by 135. Confirm. So again, I need splines from this point over here. Confirm another spline. Yeah, show that sketch from this point to the origin. Confirm another one from this point to the origin. Okay, let's try once more from this point here to that point here. Yeah, and then from this point to that point as well. Confirm. So that last one didn't quite work. Happens. Hide maybe the first sketch. Okay, let's try another spline from this point, yeah, to that point. No. Then do the fill surfaces. I'll go for a fill here, there, there. Confirm. And then add the other surfaces. So I'll go for a add, merge with this one, of course. Merge scope would be that one. And the edges, this edge, and this one. Confirm. Another fill, add. Now merge it with these. Go for edge. Now select, yeah, this one. That one. Confirm and add another one. Add now to this surface, and the edges would be, one would be here, one up there, and the last one here. Yes, and confirm. Now bring back our first surface as a, well, the second one. Well, the surface is, there you go, that's the second one, this one. And now trim or split, because there's no trim here. So go for a split. I want to split this surface. Okay, with that surface here. Yeah. Now, and selected entities do not split selected parts. Really? Yeah, because I got the sketch. That's so annoying. I want this surface. Yeah. Now, it has been recognized. and confirm. Now I should be able to hide that surface. Yeah, and hide this one as well. But I think there's still that. Okay, so I made a mistake. I need a copy of the first one. So delete this one. And I need an offset that surface from the first one, from that revolve. So we'll try to roll to here. Yeah. And make an offset surface. So offset surface should be here. No, there you go. No, where is the offset? Thicken. That looks like an offset, but it isn't. There is offset. And I want to offset the revolve, which right now is not visible because it's hidden. So I'll bring it back, make an offset surface with zero. Confirm. And another one from this one. So from that one, again with 0 millimeter. So I got two offset surfaces here. So maybe rename these, call this offset one, and that one offset two. Yeah, I know, I have to deselect offset two. Then roll this to the end, okay, and let's minimize this one, and that would be so that's to be hidden. That should be hidden. That's this surface and those two offsets. So hide offset two. And now I can split offset one. So go to split this surface with that surface right here and confirm. So that's the one to hide. Yeah? And hide I should of course keep the tools. Yeah, and now hide that surface 9. Let's thicken, hide those sketches or curves, hide all curves, hide that sketch. Now let's thicken that surface with 0.5, 0.5. So go for thicken this surface by 0.5 and 0.5. Confirm. Now I should be able to hide that one, at least for the moment. And now I want to subtract all other solids from this one. So let's see, let's try it like this. Go for a boolean operation, go for subtract, and the target would be this one. Now let's try to hide it. I can't hide it right here, so go there and try to hide it now. No, not possible. So bring back all the others. So show all parts, not here. Go there, go to show all parts. Now select those which should be subtracted And that would be around here, around that, maybe like this. And of course, you should deselect the part 232. Let's take a look. I think those should be inside that selection. It's a little slow on the update. This should be not. This one should. This one, that one, this one, that one, this one, that one. Let's take a look. If you go here, it should be included. Okay, go there. This should be included. That should be included. This one, that one, no, 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 no. That's really hard to tell. This one should. This one should. That one, this one, that one, no. Go there, take a look. So what's missing? This should be not. That one should. This one should. This one should. That one should. This one should. Okay. So this one, that one, this one, that one. And this one, no. Let's take a look again. That looks okay. Oh, there's one missing. This one is missing. Now that seems to be okay. So confirm and see if it works. Yep. Yeah. So hide all the other bodies. So go there, right click, hide other parts. So that would be part 75. Great. Now, could I try to extend the one offset surface, this one? I'm not sure, but if I want to use that one, that offset surface, the trimmed one, the splitted one, could I expand that to the sides? That should be possible by no move boundary. So if I go for tangent propagation and 5 millimeters, let's take a look. If I select this one, that one. This one. And that one could work. Let's confirm this and take a look at that surface. Looks nice, so it might work. Now I have to split it with that surface 9. That would be the split tool. So go for a split. I want to split this surface here with that surface 9 and confirm. So I could hide that surface and I could thicken this surface. So thicken would be here, thicken. Direction 1 should be take a look. This goes up, yeah, but I don't need 5, I need just 2 millimeter and 3 millimeter to the other side. And confirm. Yeah, that looks okay, and I could already make a union, but before I have to make the fillets here. So go for fillets. 10 millimeter on the inside. Would be one here. One there. Here, and of course there as well. Confirm, then go for a 15 millimeter fillet. On the outside edges here, there, here, and over there, and confirm. And now I could make a union, and why not? Let's make a union. Go for union, yes, this body and that body, and confirm. Looks okay. Now let's hide this surface and bring back that offset 2 or offset 1 still there. Yeah, it's still there, so bring it back and hide that part for the moment. Now I want to extend that by 25 millimeters, so let's go for that move boundary 25, yes, this edge, that one, this one, and that one. Confirm. Looks okay. And again, trim it. Oh, I forgot to keep the tool. Yeah, of course I want to keep the tools here, so I could use it again, and I want to use it again. Two. This one, yeah. So let's split this surface with that surface 9 here and confirm. Hide this one and thicken that one with 1 millimeter to both sides. So go for thicken this one 1 millimeter and 1 millimeter. Hide the surface, bring back part 75, but before again make fillets here. So one fillet on the inside, let's go for 10 here, there, here, and over there. Confirm. Another fillet with 20 millimeters on the outside here. This one. That one. And the last one would be this one. Okay, and confirm. Now bring back part 75. This should look quite good. Hide that plane here, or hide all planes. And make a union. So go for a union. This part and that part. And confirm. Looks good. Now, can we do a chamfer? So chamfer would be here, 0.5. Let's see if it goes all around. Maybe, maybe not. We will see. No, it doesn't go all around. No, it does. It just does the preview wrong. And do another chamfer. Again, 0.5. On this edge here. Goes all around, yes, and confirm. And I'm done. So I hope you enjoyed this one. If you did, please give it a like or leave a comment. If you want to see more, please give it a like or leave a comment. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Please subscribe to my Facebook fan page. Would be very nice of you. I want to get more likes and subscriptions over there as well. Thanks for watching. See you to the next one. Bye bye.